open and I'll go. I never step foot in the path to follow.
Ain't no shaking these bones and
that's the rest, and I'm passing on.
I've been switching these ropes and hopes to find a place to call my own.
Hello, hello! What's up, everybody? I'm sorry, again, it's another windy day, but it is a beautiful one today. I am actually going, if you check out below, there's another video about charcuterie, butchering pigs and making fancy hams and everything. Well, we're going back. Today is sausage day. A pig was recently butchered, actually probably a few pigs, and this gentleman, he is actually a physician. He is going to be making sausage today. That's a hell of a hobby for a surgeon. I don't know, maybe a little Freudian. But we're going to do that today. Let me show you how beautiful it is out today. Look at that. I just realized that you could see part of Penn's Creek. You could see the dancing lights right there. I don't know if you can see that. Beautiful day, not a cloud in the sky. It's weird because, oh, there's an airplane. But yeah, sometimes there's a lot of airplanes flying by in the morning. Sometimes there's not. All right, guys, let's get to cooking. Okay, so I came down here to the farm to meet Brian. And he asked me for a favor. He said, hey, I'm getting rid of all this big farm equipment. And we were going to drive it to Center Hall to the auction. But I was inquiring about how much you would get for this stuff. And it's really not much. So he's willing to give me everything. And I can make art. And I can plow the field, which we're going to be doing in a couple days. So let me show you what I'm getting. Some kind of plow. This is a seed planter, or it actually levels out the ground. Oh wow. Corn picker. This is all going to quarry with me. Thank you, Brian. This thing too. Big dick.
Big dick.
We're gonna make some hot dogs.
What?
We made breakfast, Italian,
broth. Oh, that's
cool. Broth was the first one, so it was
like breakfast sausage?
Yeah,
raw pig?
Do you have enough freezer space, Jimmy?
What's that?
The only freezer downstairs is the one by the refrigerator, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you got enough freezer space.
Going down, I want to take that one down.
That's sheep?
That's sheep casing, yep.
Oh.
So they're a little smaller. I like, they're a little harder to work with, but
oh, you put the whole thing on.
Yep. It's like putting it on a condom.
On the dick.
On the big dick. What's that?
Venison broth. What's that? Where's the brush? You're
taking
down.
I
took them down.
Here,
just start with that.
Okay, good. Start cranking.
Slowly, right?
Yep. Mm-hmm. Get a little more. Keep on going a little faster.
Oh, and then you twist them, all right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Doing it a little faster, you're good. That's good. Keep on down. That's hard. The mixture's stiff, plus this tube is stiff. And it's a small diameter. It's really cool. You'll see the difference once you do another. You switch to a bigger casing. Stop. Go backwards. Just loop half crank or two. Great.
Yes.
So I had a quick job. Gotta pick some sage. And where else would you get sage from for fresh sausage? But from a sage plant
in front of his beautiful house.
That's the sausage room.
And that's the south facing side. Solar.
Alright, so here we are at the smoker. This is a lot nicer than the other smokers I've seen. The wooden ones. This is all stonework, and there are the sausages. Actually, those are hot dogs. Ooh,
those small casings.
We're gonna try something. I'm gonna try it to see if it works.
Something different on the floor than the pan of rice.
Yeah.
These are hog casings. This is smoked bacon? Oh yeah, you can smell
this. Yeah,
yeah.
Wow. Yes, indeedy.
So technically you don't have to cook this?
I mean, it's just fine to eat it? Technically you could eat this as is.
How do you spell done? D-U-N, right?
D-O-N.
What is that right there, pastrami?
What is it?
Pastrami.
All right, what a freaking crazy day that was. But we got a lot of meat done, got a process. I mean, Brian took home boxes and boxes of really good Italian sausage, breakfast sausages, all kind of pepperoni. I mean, crazy. I, you know, when you think of grocery stores one day not being full or something ever happening and like, oh my God, we can't get our food. There's so much food out here. It's amazing, you know, in people's freezers, but yeah, it's pretty cool. It's pretty darn cool. I mean, it wouldn't last too long, but you know, you gotta do what you gotta do. But you know, thinking about like how much meat was there and how, you know, they're like, ah, you take this, I got too much, you know, too much bacon, I got too much ground beef, I got too much this, too much that. It's pretty fascinating to really understand that you can truly be self-sufficient in an area like this. As long as you have some land and, you know, a couple pigs and a cow. I mean, I have 30 acres. I don't even need that. Actually, I'm not going to have 30 acres. It's going to be 23 plus 8. Is it 8? That would be 30. 6? I don't know. Like 28. 29 acres, I don't know, whatever. More than 5 acres. I mean, you could literally do this on 5 acres, like 4 acres, 3, I don't know. It's amazing. But that's all I gotta say. I had a great time today hanging out with the local guys, the butcher. Actually, the butcher wasn't there. Man, my hair is horrible. I have to get a haircut soon, but I don't have my trimmers, my zzzz, because I cut my hair myself, but they're still in Jersey City. I don't know. Alright guys, I hope you're enjoying the video. Sorry, it's kind of hard to edit them. I mean, I'm trying to do a lot of editing, just so you don't watch a lot of boring stuff. So, I don't know, it's been busy weekend. My cat, Johnny Cat, got a bone, and I was feeding him some meat with my hand, and he bit me. You know, he thought it was a piece of meat because I had it there, and he, and a cat's bite is really strong. You know, he bites me all the time when you play fight, but, his really, I mean, I have a really bad, couple holes, two holes, you know, like that. And one of them, I mean, it was just pouring out blood. Whatever. I knew he didn't like me. Just wanted to eat me. Anyway, guys, hope you're enjoying the videos. Sorry they haven't been as frequent as I wanted to, but I got a lot of stuff going on, and the internet kind of stinks, you know. I called Verizon, they're going to be tweaking the tower, hopefully. I know how to talk to them in their terms to get them to do what I want. What else? Oh, the cabin that I was staying at is somewhere, I don't know, whatever. That'll be another video. La 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 la. And you got a bone too. Right there. There's the ear. See how the pointy is? Pointy is either. There's Round Top Mountain. Now it's called, what is it called? Winkleblick. Stupid. I don't know. I call it Round Top because that's what the natives called it. Anyway, I hope you're enjoying my videos. Please, I need to get to 1,000 subscribers. I didn't even think I would be up to 500 this soon, but if anybody out there wants to share, sharing is caring. I'm thinking of, you know, maybe everybody that shares one of my videos or tells their friends about it. This is to hypnotize you by, I don't know if it's working, but anybody that does that, I will send you a sticker, a Dennis Allen sticker. It's the logo that appears in the front in the opening where it says whatever. I don't know, I like doing that. Sorry, it might be distracting. But if you share it, let me know in the comments and DM me, that's direct message me, an address, and I will send you a Dennis Allen City Boy Homestead sticker. It's all I could really offer you. I was thinking about giving everybody like a car or a motorcycle, but I don't have the money. So you could do it without the sticker too. Share it with your friends, like my videos, please comment on them, do whatever you gotta do. I think this YouTube thing is pretty fun. I'm enjoying it, I'm a good time, hopefully you are too. And I will see you guys on the flip side. I've always been home. Not bad for a sound check. Hey, what'd you get? Careful, Eddie, leave it. Eddie, he might not be dead. That's called the possum, and they play like they're sleeping.
Good boy, Eddie.
Eddie is still alive. See, it's breathing. He's still alive, Eddie. You gotta leave him alone, alright? Leave him. Nope. Yeah.
What's up, Mama Thun?